Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO, DPC Technology, and today I've got an amazing one. A lot of people ask me all the time about stacking NVRs, about having multiple locations, and how to handle that. And to be quite frank, the stacking of NVRs has been a little bit problematic. You'll see in the forums people asking questions about it and saying maybe it's a little bit flaky. I have never done UNVR stacking. I have a UNVR and I have UNVR Pro. But you have to have them be identical units to stack, so I've never stacked those two units. As a matter of fact, I don't use my UNVR now that I got the UNVR Pro. But anyways, the solution to all these problems now is called a Vantage Point, and it's a way of combining NVRs together to have one screen. At this point, you can do it up to three NVRs, and they can be of dissimilar types. So today I'm gonna show you how I'm combining a UNVR, a UNVR Pro, and a cloud key, and a couple different options here. So anyways, let's dive into the software and I'll show you what I mean here. So you can see this is a 4-up, and if you've watched my videos for a while, you're like, Clay, that looks like regular old, you know, a view of your office. Well, what I will tell you is the top two images here are on the UNVR Pro, and the bottom two images are running on my UNVR, and I have them in one instance. So let me show you how I did this. I'm gonna go into Site Manager, and you do have to use Site Manager to get this to work. Obviously, I use UID, and so I go to Site Manager from UID. I'm not sure everybody uses UID Enterprise, so just go into your Site Manager, however you've got that set up for your site, and you'll see all your different devices. This is actually a different one than I first showed you. This is a group of Yellow House, which is my mother's house in New Hampshire, the UNVR Pro here, which is still my main unit, and the Cloud Key here. So you can do up to three units, and on this other one, I've got a Cloud Key, UNVR Pro, and UNVR. And one of the things there is I have included the UNVR in two different groups. So you can only do three per Vantage Point. Future Clay here, I just wanna jump in real quick and say that I am using two different Unifi accounts here to do this. So there's one account that is my main account here, and I have a second account that I use for testing. I've given access to the UNVR to that second account, and actually the Yellow House NVR is on a third account that's using my mom's cloud key on her account. I've just given access to those to my second account. So three are on one account, three are on another account. If you want to set up more than three or have more than one viewpoint, you only get one viewpoint per account. So I can set up two different viewpoints with two accounts or three different viewpoints with three accounts. That can get a little complicated, but obviously if you've got more than three controllers, you probably know how to work around that. So anyways, back to the implementation. We actually have five locations at DPC Technology. So we have our Jacksonville office, Orlando office, a Destin office, an Atlanta office, and a Columbia, South Carolina office. And so my goal here is to have protect in all four of those offices and be able to see it in a couple of different screens. And I'll show you how quick and easy it is to do that. In Site Manager at this point, I have to click on Site Manager Early Access. Obviously, this is early access at this point. It may look different by the time I release this video and you see it, but for me, I have to go in here and turn on Site Manager Early Access. That's just clicking your little icon up in the corner and clicking there. So once I've done that, once I've enabled that, you'll see Vantage Point comes on. I'll actually turn it off real quick, and you'll see that Vantage Point goes away. And if I turn it on, Vantage Point comes back. So once I've got that up and running, all I have to do is click on Vantage Point here in Site Manager, and it will ask you which ones that you want to, which devices you want to have in that queue or in that Vantage Point. You just click the, I had this in full screen view. If you just click the little button there, you can see there's a button here for manage NVRs, and I can go in here and I can add or remove them. And this is basically back to that first setup screen that I was talking about. So you can do up to three, and I'll go ahead and click that. And you can go back whenever you want to. You could add or remove here. I will also say, I mentioned multiple accounts to set this up. I could go back in here and I can dynamically manage different NVRs. If there were more, I could add or remove here. I do know that they are planning on adding the ability to do more in the future. So right now you're limited to three, but for now, this is another way you can dynamically change that. If I had six in my list here, I could go back and change them. So anyways, that's that. Back to the video. I'm gonna go in here and I'll make a new multi-grid here, and I will use the 4-up, and I'll go AI Pro, which you always see. But you'll notice here, I've got backyard, and for anybody that knows Florida, you'll recognize that that is not Jacksonville, Florida. And we'll go front door, and I'll go save. I could make this a 16-up, I could make this whatever I wanted to as far as your regular views, but this is now an instance of Protect that is sharing images from New Hampshire and Jacksonville, Florida on a Cloud Key and a UNVR Pro, and it's just interchangeable. I can click on either one of them. I can scrub timelines. I can go to the timeline and go backwards and forwards, and everything just works as normal. It really is completely seamless, as if it's on one machine. I get recognitions, I get detections, I get everything just as if it's a normal Protect instance. So all my license plates that are on the NVR are showing up there. All the detections are on there. On the detections, you do have to choose them from the drop down here. They aren't all on the same one, so you have to go back and forth through them. So just putting that out there, that you in detections, you do see all the detections from both units, but you do have to drop them down from the menu really quickly just to see exactly which one you're looking for. It doesn't matter that you have different devices. So like I said, anything that will run Protect, I'm using a cloud key here. I'm assuming it will work on all the UDM products. Basically anything that you have in Protect and in your site manager, you can now mix and match. But you can only do up to three. So what would I do if I wanted to do more than three? Well, I would just keep a couple of tabs open. And obviously you're not gonna look at 50 cameras at once anyway. So this, I've got Orlando and Jacksonville. And in the, and I could, obviously, because I only have three locations here that I'm doing, I could have done them all in one instance, but I'm showing you, if you wanted to go beyond three, you certainly could just mix and match. Both of these different site manager instances include the UNVR Pro, and you can see the UNVR Pro, the AI Pro is in both of these with these two. They are actively in Jacksonville now, but I actually took my old UNVR and I've repartitioned it now, and I'm shipping it out to Orlando tonight, and these cameras will be, I've partitioned them, and they will be in Orlando. And I will show you here in the list of devices here, this is the Orlando UNVR. So very cool and really simple to do, elegant installation. Obviously it's seamless, so there's really nothing that I've done here, but everything else functions just totally like normal. This is an amazing new feature. I'm really, really stoked about it. And just like that, I can have all these different views up. Super easy. Now I don't have to worry about things being the exact same. I can mix and match hardware. For me, I'm able to restore that UNVR, which has just been sitting there. And a small shout out to Unifi. That was on 1.4.9. I think I got my UNVR maybe a couple years ago. And so in those last 2 years, I fired that thing up and it was on 1.4.9 and it looked so ancient. It was amazing. It did take a long time for it to upgrade, by the way. I probably took me most of the morning to go through all those points. I had to go all through all the twos, all the threes, and up to four to get it where it is now. As well, you know, you may have some issues with doing this if you don't have all of your controllers on the latest, greatest. I am in pre-release versions here, but by the time this video gets to you, it will be available. And just make sure that you have gone to the latest version of the software that you can get. And it should, you know, obviously update the firmware in your controller and then update your version of Protect to make sure that it runs with all of the features that it needs to have. If I just wanted to go back and go just to Yellow House's NVR again, I can just go into Protect and boom, I'm just into Yellow House. And if I want to go right back into Vantage Point, I can just click right back into Vantage Point. But super easy, super simple. And again, another addition that Unifi has done at zero cost. I mentioned updating my UNVR from 1.4.9. The amount of functionality that we've gotten from that unit that was, you know, based off of the purchase, you know, 2-3 years ago, and the functionality that's been added to it over that time is amazing. And my hat's off to Unifi for continuing to innovate these kind of things. Well, yeah, with this, I don't see a real reason that you would ever nest a couple of NVRs, because all of the functionality that I see that you probably would need is here in Vantage Point. There are a couple limitations here. First, you are gonna have to unstack your current NVRs to make Vantage Point work. And second of all, you're not able to use the cloud archiving tools with the current setup. And the third thing, this is English only at the moment. But other than that, I don't see any reason that I would stack NVRs versus using Vantage Point. If you haven't used Site Manager before, you want me to dive into that at all, please leave that down in the comments down below. Anything else you want me to test on this system, let me know. But for now, super amazing addition. Hats off again to Unifi for doing it, and we'll see you guys in the next video.